special night inside Bud Walton Arena. Senior night for the Razorbacks, and Arkansas hosts number 14, Auburn. Anton Beard, one of the seniors, honored pregame, hits the three.
And Kevin, he might be the key.
Here's Barford, doesn't only shoot, he could drive inside the paint. Trey Thompson, and the follow inside. Good look, it was Orlando Cook. Arkansas has only lost in this building twice. Mainly because of what Darryl Macon has done from beyond the arc.
Hard bounce, quick leap, quick release.
Did you say loud before?
And it's amazing what the two guys have accomplished in Arkansas uniform.
And Heron answers quick attack. They've got great
tough mess on the outside.
That's why a player like Brown has scored over 16 a game. Barford again.
You know what's amazing? What's surprising so far for me, Kevin, is Barford has had open looks. I mean, he's having open looks. Miscommunication by the Tigers on the defensive end.
Already three triples for the Razorbacks. Harper penetrates. Murray lost it on the way up. And there's Jared Harper, the sophomore point guard from Ableton, Georgia.
And Mike Anderson, they're trying to corral Harper out front with two guys. Look how quickly Macon gets off his feet. Another one. And I'll tell you what, when a shooter does what he's doing, and that means he's releasing, and when it's halfway up, he's almost looking to the crowd like, yeah, it's net. He could have a massive night. All he needs is a teammate to give him some picks as he's bringing the ball down the floor.
Auburn's points again coming inside. Murray. Feels like a tidal wave on this end of the floor. Auburn's only down four.
Tip back in. Did we mention it's senior night? You know what? I look at those three games that happened before us. Missouri
had a chance
on the road
all
this stretch. Kind of turned that one, I remember. Then you don't know where it leads to. But there's a number of
four guys' minutes, and so far they've responded. McLemore, still the SEC's block leader. Close to three a game. He's missed the last two you mentioned.
Yes, it's your night. But they play the way we play, and the freshman misses statement.
Is shocking his own teammate with
better because of the veteran players he has,
including Macon. Another three.
I would face guard Macon and not let him freedom. Active hands knocks it off of Harper's foot.
Have an easy layup in the game.
And Trey Thompson blocked it from behind on a hustle play.
Spencer's basket has it back to a 4-point game. This run has taken the crowd out just momentarily. Beard misses. Brown runs. 2-point game.
And the difference
Arkansas doesn't give away the basketball frequently either.
Anton Beard just dribbled it for 22 seconds. You know, you got a lucky break. And if you're the point guard, it's your freshman bails you out.
Dunbar lost it. Macon is running. Good look. Gaffer.
And welcome back, Bud Walton. Huh? Wow, the noise.
Three blocks, two dunks for Gaffer. Macon recovers, but Heron drives, and another block. Running, Macon. These two teams average plenty of possessions. We expect a high-scoring game. There's C.J. Jones. You just pointed him out a few moments ago.
13.
Here's Gafford. He stretches out. Knocks down the jumper.
And we talk sometimes wow. About guys playing in the paint. There's not a no-fly zone here at Bud Walton. Daniel Gafford is a stud and likes to finish it with authority. Razorbacks back on a roll.
C.J. Jones knocked down his shots a few moments ago. Hits it up.
So Bryce Brown, C.J.
To Arkansas, back to back to finish the year.
There he is with another 10. Daniel Gafford. The band he's at Ole Miss, he's pretty good. Deshaun Murray's another drummer from Auburn.
There's Mitchell with the band.
Auburn, and it'll be loud at Tennessee.
There's Barford.
Trey Thompson catches in the post. Barford's up top.
Mines. On senior night. Heron at the horn. That's a big one to get it back to 10.
That's perfect execution.
Yeah.
On one end, it's
Auburn needs to win to clinch a share of the SEC regular season title.
They need to stop that high-flying act. Gafford with another slam.
Just underneath the hoop. They're looking for him.
Great dish, and Gafford scores again.
Smart play by Barford. He waited, thought about trying to get his own shot, just waited. Gafford didn't have great.
They got to get a stop or two on this end.
Why not?
Gafford again.
Why not?
He's up 6-0 in the second half.
And it was senior Barford on one side. This time it's Macon.
15 points. And the fans at Bud Walton Arena show their appreciation for the freshman.
We can't paint this picture enough with foul trouble in the paint for Auburn and a miss on this side.
And I would think.
Here we go. Here's
money.
Macon.
That's money. That's money all night. It's perfect. 5-5. 4-4 beyond the 3-point line. I mean, I saw it in the first half. His catch and release, once it's out of the fingertips, I mean, he's done with it. It's like
the exact mirror of January 6th when Auburn was better than 50% from the field. And Heron, he snaps the streak.
This league is not the best player.
He's right at his average. We've got plenty of time in the second. Dustin Thomas, contagious. Everybody is hitting all around the floor tonight.
If that would have gone, Auburn, they should just, let's just call this one off.
There's Harper. Single digit.
Indiana.
Just like
Indiana
that.
Team, number one seed. Chris Porter, obviously SEC Player of the Year. The Dallas National Coach of the Year. And wow. Totally dominant.
So
because of the size.
Deflection. Auburn loves to run. Maybe the best of the conference at this.
C.J. Jones keep paying him up.
Catch, release. He's not supposed to swing.
No thought.
He's going to look this time.
Beard on the drive, and that may make up for the errant pass a few possessions ago. Arkansas back up by 12.
I'm laughing because that's a senior. He knows the guy sitting on the sideline is going to take him out.
Jones with the steal. Beard going up, and he's
all their energy back.
This is Orlando Cook.
Hit on the arm. Send him to the free throw line for one more.
Rebound to Gaffney.
What a tough night shooting the ball, but
Jalen Barford.
Auburn can't buy one. 6 of 22. Harper now 1 of 7.
And that's what they lived by most of the season. Just 35% from the field.
That one bounces down. They're falling.
Yeah, did I mention early in the first half I thought Barford had a quicker step tonight? Did he really go to work?
There he is. He's at the right palm stretched out. Miscommunication. Macon gives to Gafford. Unselfish play.
Wow, 2-on-2. He brought both defenders to it. This is how you run a break if you're out ahead. Bring both guys to the party.
Oh.
Shuffle it off. Wow. Got them both, didn't he? Set them both up. Another man. And their players respond. Perfect night still by Macon.
Macon is shaking his head back and forth, almost to say,
Macon likes to get all
no one leaves it for Gafford.
And he jams another one in. It's happened all night long.
Perkins been really good off the dribble.
He's had a lot of terrific assists.
Most of them to Gafford. Freshman Macon again. Good off the dribble. Drops it off. And Daniel Gafford dunks from about every angle.
On the roster for the Hawks. And the one walk-on of senior for Arkansas, JT Plummer. Darryl Macon and his teammates were pushing him down the bench to get him towards the scorer's table. And here he comes.
And he will finish with his senior teammates on the floor. The only one out now is Barber.
One more time for Macon. Off they go. Final time inside Bud Walton Arena. Arkansas flips the script for the last time these two met. 91 points and a victory over number 14 Auburn.
Good performance. The Razorbacks are playing well. Offensively, they've been terrific.